National Science Day celebration 2021. In spite of this period, because for the first time we are having this period as an exam period, generally exams are over by December, maximum by January first week, but this year because of the COVID-19, exams are going on. And because of this reason, we are trying to recover the time lost in 2020, so that in coming years, we are able to catch up our normal academic calendar and give full benefit to the students. In doing so, the exams have been little late compared to our earlier years, and you all mentally were preparing for that. So we thought that at least at a level of small approach towards celebration, we should observe all COVID-19 parameters as well as see our concern toward the National Science Day celebration. That is why we have not organized the exhibitions and other things which we used to generally organize to give opportunity to the students to show their, through the moral, the creativity and innovation. And in this way, we have more involvement, but in last 1 or 2 days, our students have also shown the interest, particularly in participating different activities, for which I am sure the result will come out shortly. But as you are aware, that why the National Science Day? You know, our first Nobel Prize winner, Sir Chandrasekhar Raman, who has done work in Indian Association of Science and Culture, Kolkata, got the Nobel Prize in 1930. But on 28 February 1928, his paper was published on the diffraction of wavelength. And you know, he was not working as a scientist anywhere. He was working as an assistant related to the accounts and other things. But because of his interest, he used to go and work in this Association of Science Culture in Calcutta, where people can go and work. So first thing comes your interest to achieve any big thing. The second thing comes the observation, your observation, what is happening, and questioning your observation, why it is happening. In science, these are very important things, that first of all, you must have interest to find something new, and when you want to find something new, you should question why it is happening, what are those factors, is there any effect by the environment or by external force. So these things have to be seen. This was very simple study, that when any wavelength passed through the molecule, some of the wavelength get diffracted. Is different. Very simple thing, anybody will say. But this diffraction he called as a different effect, or which is now known as Raman effect. So the Raman effect has been come given so many new areas, Raman spectrophotometry, and also it has also given new things, development of laser and other things, so many things have come. So that the new area in science were opened. So anybody giving Nobel Prize is only based that when new area is given, which has got so many new researches to come. At that time, you can just imagine that no sophisticated instruments were available. No modern lab facilities were available. No additional funding was available to him to carry out research. But his own and very inquisitiveness, that is what we say, that the best outcome could be when you are having deep learning about the subject and you want to see after your MSc how you can apply, how you can generate the interest. So these were the things, and after this it continued only in 1986. Then our National Science Academy and these things, they held the meeting that we must observe getting his Nobel Prize, first Nobel Prize in science from India, as in the form of celebration, so that school children, college students, university students are given opportunity to create awareness and to motivate them that they should have scientific observations, very inquisitiveness inside them, so that they have a new ideas how to convert them to solve the problems or to create a new things. For example, the flowers have different colors. How they develop the different colors? Is it due to the absorbance of the light? Because before developing the different colors, they all have green colors, the leaf and other things. So how this green color, that is the chloroplast, can have the machinery to absorb certain wavelength and convert into different colors? This was the diffraction. Based on the diffraction, he explained so many things. So his researches were not only confined to physics or like that, basically he was physicist, but having wide application in biological science, in chemical science and physics of course. So large area of applications were there. So in 1987, the first National Science Day was observed, and thereafter every year on 28th February we observe. But because tomorrow is Sunday and also because of the examinations, so we thought let us have on 27th. That is how we are celebrating one day in advance. So one day in advance is always better than having after 28th. Because then, though we have received the notification from government of Meghalaya that organize Science Day in the month of March, but we thought no, it is better to organize on 27th rather than going for March. So you all are here. Now after that, as you know, our some more Nobel Prize winners are there in the field of science, and their researches are also to learn that how we may not have the more facilities, but if our ideas are there and if these ideas can be converted into a new things, either as a form of our some giving theory or explaining the solution, giving the solutions which gives wider applications, can get the award. So for us, this is one motivational way of celebration, as well as creating more creative thinking. Generally what we feel, that good research can only be done in most modern facilities, but there we can only do good work of repetitive type, not the original type. We have seen most of our publications are those which are confirmed in confirmation with those researches which have already been done outside. Because in international journal, generally they publish such papers which are in conformity with those researches. This paper, which was published in a very simple journal, so most of those earlier work which have been awarded in various awards, including the Nobel Prize, they have not been published in very good or international journals. Even there are some bulletins, but these were having the very wider aspects, as I said, of application. So for us, we have to also see that what we see in nature, nature is the biggest laboratory for anyone, whether biology or chemistry or physics, and how the phenomenon going on under the natural processes, how the interaction of different forces, how the interaction between the different interaction between the molecules, between the physical aspects, and how it is changing remains unknown so far. Or whatever is now written is mostly needs scientific proof. So because of lack of the scientific proof, many of our Indian science is not getting recognition. So for us, it is now necessary that to see those traditional scientific knowledge which is there so much in this Northeast, we have to prove scientifically, provide the scientific reason for those aspects so that they can get recognition internationally and we can maybe open the new areas. For example, you see, there has been the distance measurement 2000 years back, but not in kilometer. Now it is going to be in kilometer. What were those instruments? How they could measure this? Now it is coming true, getting true. So can we develop this? As you see, even another our scientist Bose, he was also going to get the Nobel Prize because he was the first person to say the plants also have life. But this was proved by outside. He measured even using this, the life and all these things with the simple kind of the instruments. So fabrication is another part of converting your ideas into measuring the things. Because today, the preciseness of measurement is very important. So many now instruments are available so that those precisions can give that beyond that no further deviation is there. A number of areas as here are represented, biological science, physical sciences, chemical sciences, they have their own areas where new researches can be done, and these researches can be applied to solve the problem, to solve the problems related to environment or related to society. And that is why every year we develop some special theme for Science Day. And I am happy that because of this approach and also creating confidence in our scientists, for the first time, India has produced 2 vaccines. You all know that last year, whole world has suffered because of COVID-19. They never expected that all of a sudden, a new viral strain, COVID-19, will come. And it was spreading so fast that all over the world, within no time, it has reached. And even those advanced countries were unable to find the control, because the control could be either natural control by another vector or by producing the vaccine. So the production of vaccine may take sometimes years together. Some of the virus are still not having any vaccine. They have been discovered 20 years back, more than 20 years back, say for example, AIDS virus, so far no vaccine is available. But this virus made concern to each and every citizen of the world because it is spreading all over the world. Whereas other viruses were confined as well as some source was known of their spread. So many countries were working, and our country, which has not having any experience in developing, in producing, it has experience producing 60-70% of vaccine which have already discovered in other country, but not having its own, producing its own for the first time. So once you feel that this is the challenge and I have to solve the problem, and if you get encouragement, then you are going to get success in that. So first of all, in science is getting a good problem which becomes throughout the many years same. Doesn't matter whether the person is having PhD or not PhD, no. Many examples are there. Mendel, you biological students, they all know, he was not having any PG or PhD, but he was having inquisitiveness and very good, or you can say that observation was such to the point that whatever variation was coming in the flowering stage, that inquisitiveness developed the theories, then his all experiments gave different kinds of this without any degree also. But those have been now proved scientifically, and those terms which were used by Indians, the gene term has been used by Indians, that this genes is very good. We always say genes means they meant variety. So, but we did not pick up, we were only followers. So now time has come. Now, beside the followers, we have to be discoverer to those problems which are already available. And nobody should think that within these limited facilities, whether we can create good research papers. You can certainly create good research papers, good publication, if you have a good innovative, original idea. That is more important. To bring out the ideas from the youngsters, because you will see as we become old, the new ideas are less. As you are young, the new ideas are more. That you can find even in the young children. But generally we suppress those ideas. We do not give enough chance to develop these ideas into some theory or in explaining, or okay, you work out your ideas. So because we believe, suppose those ideas are not giving good result as we are expecting, what will happen? So that means we are not even in science able to take risk. That is now necessary. It may take more time, but if that idea can give rise to new approach in solution finding as a science. So 2021, COVID-19 became one of the theme. So every year, as I said, the new theme, pupil for science, science for pupil, women, science for women, like that, every year new theme comes. So the themes, and you will find that theme comes as per solutions from science to the society. So we have to also see that whatever scientists think for doing their research, it should also be giving some solution to the society's problem. That will be the best approach of doing research in science. So without taking much time, because we all have our different research areas, we try to contribute in those areas and try to find some solutions. And so many our scientists are here. We did not invite from outside experts, but we thought that we will share our these things and also encourage the youngsters to participate as well as to contribute in the scientific studies in their own interest, and then take the your idea and new thinking into converting some aspects of your results. So thank you very much. I personally thank head of the Department of Zoology and all faculty members from Zoology who have taken this lead to organize the National Science Day. So thank you very much. Thank you so much.